Hello everyone, today's video is about the Venn diagrams and here we will consider most of the questions with three sets. Okay, and the questions you need not to be solved only with the help of a formula because we are just having a single formula, but you need to understand the concept, how we can evaluate different types of questions, how can we solve them using the basic understanding of Venn diagrams. Okay, let's start it. Okay, this is a very first question. Here the diagram is already built in and we have to answer few of the questions. The first, in this diagram they have given us the three sets. One is skiing, another is sailing, and the last one is swimming. Okay, so they say it is for the students. Now what they said, 8 students are there which are not like any of these, like which are not in the swimming, which are not participating in sailing, and which are not participating in skiing as well. Okay, so this 8 is representing like none of these three. All right, now how many students only like sailing? Only like sailing, if I shade that region, only sailing means nothing else, so that will be this region, this one. If I highlight it again, so this is the region only like sailing. There is nothing skiing or swimming element in it. So how many elements are those? 17. So the first answer would be 17. Now second comes, how many students like both skiing and sailing? Okay, so now what I do, I rub this thing. Now I have to answer, how many students like both skiing and sailing? Both skiing and sailing means common, so that is this one, means 21 plus 19 is equivalent to 40. Okay, next comes, how many students like sailing or swimming? Now see, here it was and here it is or, and this is for sailing and swimming, sailing or swimming. Now how to represent this thing, sailing or swimming? So swimming is this total and sailing is this total, right? But we have to evaluate everything only one time. So what you can do here, either you add all of these, okay, and then when you add this one, so what will be remaining? 21 and 17. So add all these terms first. I repeat again, see, there are two methods. The simplest method is you have to count sailing or swimming. So sailing is this total, this is swimming, okay, and this is sailing. So means we can add all the numbers which are coming in between. So 21, then 19, then 16, 13, 20 and 17. So basically what will be the answer? This 21 here is only this part, okay, so I can add all of these parts. So 21 plus 19 plus 16 plus this 20 plus 13 plus 17. Those students like sailing or swimming. They have not said only sailing and swimming. They said sailing and swimming, so skiing can also be there, but sailing or swimming they are having for sure. Next comes, let me rub all of these. Next comes, how many students like both skiing and swimming but not sailing? Now how many students like both skiing and swimming? Skiing and swimming, how many students are there which are liking both skiing and swimming? 16 plus 19, but they said not sailing. So what is the sailing portion out of it? This 19. So we will remove this 19. So we will get just 16. Okay, so just go step by step. Next, how many students do not like either skiing or swimming? So how many students are there who either don't like skiing or swimming? So either they don't like skiing or swimming. So skiing is how much? This total. So it should be either they should not like skiing or they should not like swimming. So if I consider this 16, see what they said here. How many students do not like skiing or swimming? Okay, skiing is, or this is skiing, first write skiing or swimming. Okay, you have to find that one, and don't like, so one minus of that, basically like its complement, actually like its complement, skiing or this and don't like that. So if you find out its reverse, so skiing or this, it means it is this one, intersection this set. So skiing is how many and swimming are how many? Find its complement. So skiing is how many? Skiing are total these ones and swimming. So skiing is this one. Sorry. So from here skiing is this part and its complement will be this thing. This one. Okay. This is skiing complement. And swimming complement. Swimming complement is what? So swimming complement means that will be, I just highlight with the another color. That will be something like this. And then intersection of that. Now if you see what is the intersection part. One is like this. Okay. So I highlight this portion. And another is the red one. Here different colors are very useful. So if you see what is the common region. The common region is, I make the third color for the common region. So this is the common region. They said skiing or how many students do not like either skiing or swimming? So how many students will be those? These many. I think it's written 17. So 17 students will be there who either they do not like skiing or they do not like swimming. Okay. So either do not like either these. So first I write either these, and do not means their complement. And then when you open it, so A union B complement is equivalent to A complement intersection B complement. And then I found those two, A complement and B complement, and I found this is like 17. Okay. You can go step by step and coloring all of these, and then you can get your answers. Okay. Alright, next is, how many students like skiing or swimming? Skiing or swimming. So skiing or swimming is basically this one. This total. So here we have 2 plus 21 plus 16 plus 19 plus 13 plus 20. So all of that you have to write here. Okay. You have to draw it and then you can get your answers very easily. How many students like skiing or swimming but not sailing? skiing or swimming. First we write skiing or swimming. That means this, but not sailing. So what is the portion of sailing here? This total is a portion of sailing, so we will cut it. Or you can say, instead of cutting this portion, this is a requirement, not sailing. So basically what we will be left with? 2, 16 plus 13. So 2 plus 16 plus 13. Okay. You can stop the videos for each answer. Try to explain it yourself. If not, then watch video again and then do it step by step. Next comes, how many students do not like both sailing and swimming? So sailing and swimming, do not like means their complement. So sailing and swimming, first of all we will find that, or you can do it like sailing complement intersection swimming complement, whichever is easy for us. So sailing intersection swimming, first of all we will see that sailing intersection swimming, so this portion, so both they should not like, so that means they should be, which portion will be the answer? The other one, this whole. So we will give this answer. What will be that? So we find sailing and swimming are these ones. So just remove these ones. So we will get 2 plus 21 plus 17 plus 16 plus 13. Okay. Next term. Okay. How many students like both sailing and swimming? Sailing, this one, and swimming. So these are those. 19 plus 20. How many students do not like both skiing and swimming? So we already found both sailing and swimming, and you can just total you can find out and subtract this one, or you can say do not like skiing and swimming. So skiing and swimming and don't like. So skiing and swimming, first of all we will find out. Skiing and swimming, so they are these ones. So not these one means 2 plus 21 plus 17 plus 20 plus 13. So other part will be the answer. So this one, this portion will be the answer. Okay, I hope this question is clear to you. See, the main thing is don't just rely on the formulas. Go step by step. Try to understand the problem. Try to represent it in terms of the Venn diagram, which area of Venn diagram they are asking for, and then attempt it. Okay. Let's go to the next part. Okay. A group of 62 students were surveyed. And it was found that each of the students surveyed liked at least one of the following three foods. That means when we talk about the different sets, and we always consider the universal set. So here universal set is basically equivalent to the union of these three sets. You can give them name A, B, C or whatever. Okay. So this is the meaning of at least. So that means there is no student who doesn't like all of them. Okay. So this is important thing here. Now let's go to the question. 34 like apricots. So I am just making it. These are apricots. These are bananas. And 33 like cantaloupes. 33 like cantaloupes. So it is C. Now see, when the problem is given and you are drawing the diagram, always try that you start from the which is common area for all of three, then common area for two taking at one time, and then the rest. So here 34 like the apricot. So that 34 is this whole. If I highlight with some other color, so that 34 is this total. 30 bananas. 30 bananas are these ones. Then 33 cantaloupes. So those are these ones. Okay. 11 liked apricots and bananas. 15 liked bananas and cantaloupes. 17 liked apricots and cantaloupes. 19 liked exactly two of the following fruits, apricot, bananas and cantaloupes. So what we can do here? So we'll go step by step again. Okay. I am making the diagram here only. So this is the diagram. A, B and C. Let this is X. Okay. This is common to all of these three. Those are X number of students. Now they said 19 exactly like. Now see. They said 11 like apricots and bananas. Apricots and bananas 11. So that 11 is this total. So if this part is X, so how much this one will be? 11 minus X, right? Then 15 liked bananas and cantaloupes. 15 liked banana and cantaloupes. So those 15s are these ones. But X is already here, so this will be 15 minus X. 17 liked apricots and cantaloupes. So 17 are these ones. And this one will be 17 minus X. 19 liked exactly two of them. So that means exactly two is the case of this 17 minus X, because this is liked only by A and C, not by B. And there should be two, not one. Then either or this case. So what is the highlighted portion? They are asking exactly two means this one or this one or this one. Those are equivalent to 19. So that means 15 minus X plus 11 minus X plus 17 minus X is equivalent to 19. So if we add all of them, so it is 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 5, 13, 43 minus 3X is equivalent to 19. Then 43 minus 19 is equivalent to 3x. So x will be equivalent to 8. So now we found all the required values. So this is A, this is B, and this is C. I think these are 8. So it is 11 minus 8, 3. And 1 was 15 minus X, okay, so 15 minus 8, that means it will be 7. And this one was 17 minus X, so 17 minus 8, that will be 9, okay. And now the remaining pictures are given. A is, I think, 34, then B is 30, and then 33. This is 30, and this is 33. So we can easily find anything now. First of all, we found this, that okay, 8 are those which liked all of them. And if 19 are those which like 2 at one time. So either A or B, that means this region, and we already understand this thing. Okay, now let's see what they are asking for. How many students like apricots but not bananas or cantaloupes? Okay, apricots but not the other two. So, let me remake it. So, I think this was 3 and this was 15 and 7 and this was, I think, 9. Yeah. They said how many like apricots but not bananas or cantaloupes. Apricots but not of these. Neither cantaloupes, neither nor bananas. So how many will be those? That means they are asking only apricots. Okay, so what you will do, this total is 34.
if I show it, this total is 34. Okay, but I want just this part, only apricot. So that means it is 34, which is the total given, minus 9, minus 8, minus 3. So 34 minus 17 minus 3, 34 minus 20 is equivalent to 40. Okay, now next part. Same, how many students like cantaloupes but not bananas or apricots? Same way you can do it. Okay, so I am leaving this part for you. How many students liked all of the following three fruits that we have already found, this X, which is 8. How many students liked apricots and cantaloupes but not bananas? Okay, apricots, how many students? Okay, how many students like apricots and cantaloupes? These are those ones. So this was 9. So these are the students which like apricots and cantaloupes, and including the bananas also. But they said no bananas, so we will just remove it. So we are getting only 9. So that will be our answer. Okay, see, in this there are lot of questions given in this video. Okay, but I am not gonna discuss all of them. I have discussed two questions for now. I just want you to understand the basic concepts. So these are the actual Venn diagram questions with three sets. Okay, all the word problems with three sets based on the Venn diagram. I have discussed these two problems here, and more I have, I think, one more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 problems. So now I am going to discuss one more. I pick randomly. Let's see this one. These are quite easy. The first questions, few questions are a little tricky. In a college, 60 students enrolled in chemistry. So in a college, there are students, some in chemistry, 60 students. No, sorry, 60, yeah. And 40 in physics, okay. 30 in biology, okay. 15 in chemistry and physics, 10 in physics and biology, 5 in biology and chemistry. No one enrolled in all the three. No one enrolled in all the three. That means this part is 0. Okay, because this is a set, this is the part where this is a part of the students. No, those number of students which are having all of these three subjects who have taken, but they said no one is enrolled, so that means this part is 0. So that means physics intersection chemistry intersection biology is equivalent to 0 number of students. Okay, now 15 in chemistry and 15 in chemistry and physics. Chemistry and physics, so this is 15, this part is 15, and 5 in biology and chemistry. So this is 5, this portion only. If I highlight it with some other color, this portion, because this thing is 0. Okay, and this is 15, this is 5. 10 in physics and biology, so those are 10, this one. Find how many are enrolled in at least one of the subject. That means they are asking for this total. This or this or this or this. Okay. Now see. This is 15 and this is 5. So how many will be these ones? So this is 15 and this is 5. These are 20. 60 is this total. What is this 60 representing? This total. Out of them 15, 20 is here. So how many will be these? 40. Then how much is this one? These are total 40. 15 plus 10, 25 is here. So 15 are here, these ones. 10 plus 5, 15 is here. So 15 will be here. So how many are enrolled in at least one of the subjects? So those are these total. Okay. So how many are those? 40. Plus 5, You can apply the direct formula also, like A union B union C, that one also, but I think this is easiest. So 40 plus 15 plus 5, 20 plus 15 plus 5, 20, and then 15 plus 10. So here is 14, 40 plus 20, here is 15 plus, wait a minute, I think I wrote it wrong. Yeah. So this is 40 plus 20 and then 15. You have written, once you have written anything, you don't write it again. So 40 plus this 20, this part is done. Now what is left? 15, then this 10, and then 15. Be careful that you don't overwrite any of the number again. So how many are these? Okay, 4 plus 2 is 6, plus 1, 7, 8, 9, and 10. 100. But how is it possible? This is 60, 60 and 30. Okay. Yeah. So there are total 60 students, okay, in a class. Find how many are enrolled in one of the. Let's do it again. I think we have done something wrong here. Let's do it again. So this is the only thing in these questions. You have to be very careful. Okay. So there are total 60. Sorry, these 60 students were in chemistry only. So 100 was correct actually. I made a mistake. I didn't understand that thing. I forgot. I thought 60 is the total number of students. So let's do it again. They said some students are 60 students are for chemistry. So this is chemistry. This is physics, which is equivalent to 40. And here is 60. And then biology, which is equivalent to 30 students. Okay. They said none of the student is there, which is enrolling in the three subjects. All the three sub, that means this part is zero. It's okay. 15 is in the chemistry and physics. So those 15 are these ones. Okay. These are how many? 15. Then 10 in physics and biology. Okay. So 10 in physics and biology. And then 5 in biology and chemistry. Biology and chemistry. 5. So, now they said how many students are enrolled in at least one of the subjects. At least one means either this or this or this. Now we know in the breaking form, like okay, these are 15 and this one. So this total is 16. See, this total is 16. Out of this 5 is used here, 15 is here. So how much will be left? 40. Because 15 plus 5 is 20. 60 is this total. So 60 minus 20 is 40. And that 40 is this much. Then we have to find this one. So this is total 30. 5 here, 10 here. So 15 is here. Then this is 15 and this is 10. Because this is 15, this part is 0 and this is 10. So 25, so this is again 15 because 40 minus 25 is 15. So how many are there students who are enrolled in at least one of the subject? That means this or this or this. So these are 40, then 45. I am just marking, covering the regions with red. So this is 40. Then 5, this is 0, this is 15, this is 10, this thing is 15, and then remaining is 15 again. So how many students are there in total? So 15, 15, 15, 45, 45 plus 5 is 50, then it is 60. And then 40, 100. 100 students are there in total. Okay. I hope this question is clear to you. So these are the three problems I have discussed. Now rest of the problems in this video, I will discuss in the next video. Okay. Meanwhile, you concentrate on these. Try to understand. And if you don't understand, you know my number, everything. You can just
get back to me anytime. Okay, thank you. But for watching the for getting the updates about the next, like how to solve the rest of the questions, I have mentioned a lot of questions, and I beg you, if you do all of these questions sincerely, you wanna rock in SES and you will never get any problem. But you have to do better understanding, you have to try a lot of questions. Okay, and these all questions which I have mentioned in this video, no doubt I am going to explain rest of the questions which I have not explained in this video, in my next video, but you try to understand what I have taught in this video. Okay, and if you cover all of these questions, I don't think you can get anything out of these ones. Okay, everything, whichever, whatever will come, that will be based on these basic understanding of the concepts. Thank you.